So yeah, these things, Realme Buds Air, they have been around for about 3 weeks, or you could say a month, and I have been using them for a few days now. I didn't think I would buy them in the first place because, I mean, look at this thing, it's a straight up one-to-one copy of Apple AirPods. But then it got me wondering, while copying the Apple AirPods, along with the weird design choices, whether they managed to actually copy the good things as well. And short answer, yes. So this video is my in-detail summary and kind of my review of the Realme Buds Air. I won't even talk about the design because there is nothing to talk about. These things are, well, exactly like the Apple AirPods. They fit in the same footprint. They are built the same way. They are designed the same way. Except for this design by Realme logo, everything else is the same. I'm happy to see a Type-C port on the bottom for charging, and it has wireless charging support as well, which I tested does work very well, so that's great. The unboxing was fairly simple, as you might have already seen. You just get the Realme Buds and the Type-C cable to charge them up. That's it. The pairing process is quite straightforward. You first open the lid and you press and hold this button for 3 seconds, which enters pairing mode. Now you can turn on Bluetooth on any of your Android devices and scan for Bluetooth, and you will get Realme Buds Air in the available devices list. Simply pair to it and you're done. From then on, every time you open the lid, it automatically connects to your phone. It does use Bluetooth 5.0 for faster connection and saving a lot of battery, and it does work very well. My Note 9 has Bluetooth 5.0 and I can confirm the seamless connection that Realme was talking about. Now let's talk about the in-ear feel and the comfort of these things, because when I said that these were a one-to-one copy of the Apple AirPods, I meant it literally, because these exactly feel like the loose and uncomfortable feeling Apple AirPods in your ear. Surprisingly, they don't fall down on their own. Like, you can shake your head around, they won't fall off on their own, but they always feel loose. They never feel as tight as they would traditionally feel if they had rubber gaskets around them and wingtips to support your ear. Apple finally learned their lesson with the AirPods Pro and they gave the ear tips with them, but I guess we'll get that with the Realme Buds Air Pro, if that's gonna come out. Now these AirPods have been... Oh, I said AirPods. Now the Realme Buds have been designed in a very similar fashion as the Apple AirPods. You get a microphone on the back for your phone calls. There is an infrared based proximity sensor for wear detection. And then there is the sound driver, which is open towards the front. The lack of a rubber tip doesn't only hurt the fit, but it also hurts your ears when you push them in. Like when I first got them and I was trying them on, I decided to push them into my ears because that's how I typically use all of my Bluetooth truly wireless earbuds. And these plastic edges are quite sharp and they actually hurt me. So keep that in mind, like these are meant for a very loose and casual fit. They're not meant to be like sports kind of earphones which are supposed to stay on your head even when you're jogging through a jungle for some reason. But I have to applaud Realme for their attention to detail. These have been made with the precision in mind, so they don't feel any more cheaper than the AirPods themselves do. And the loose feeling in your ear doesn't really give you the confidence to wear this, especially when you're like walking around or maybe you're using public transport and stuff. So these are definitely meant for casual walks and at home listening. Now there are capacitive controls on the back of these earbuds, which are pretty much the same as Apple AirPods. Double tap on the back will pause or play your music and receive phone calls. A long press on any one of the earbuds will summon Google Assistant. A triple tap will skip to the next track, and pressing and holding both of them together will launch that super cheesy gaming mode. I like the fact that they have included a low latency mode, which probably consumes more battery. That is why it's not on by default. That's what I think. But that race car sound effect that you get when you switch on gaming mode, that is stupid. It has to go. And the sound when you switch back into normal mode, the piano playing sound, that's not much better either. Now, wear detection works pretty well. It does take it a split second longer for the music to pause when you take one earbud out of your ear, but it is a proximity sensor. If you block the proximity sensor with your finger when you take it out of your ear, the music will continue to play because it thinks that it is still in your ear. Now, while pairing these with non-Bluetooth 5.0 compatible devices like my older Galaxy Note 8, I did notice that the tap functions and the wear detection was not working for a solid 2 minutes after first pairing them. So that's something to keep in mind. If you have an older device without Bluetooth 5.0, you have to give this some time to like start working the way they're supposed to work. Now occasionally I have noticed that the audio kind of like drops off on one earbud but keeps playing on the other, and vice versa. But it only happens occasionally when I'm like really moving around with my phone and maybe there is some interference in the atmosphere. It doesn't happen all that while, and especially it doesn't happen outside when I'm like just going for a walk away from my other devices. So I don't think it's a major issue here. Definitely is an issue with shielding, so Realme has to work with the interference shielding a little bit more. But yeah, overall it's pretty great. Now coming back to that gaming mode, which is supposed to reduce the latency a lot, I personally did not observe a huge difference between gaming mode and the regular mode. I did notice that the latency in the voice and video output while watching YouTube on these was a little bit better, in the sense the latency was less when I paired these with my laptop in gaming mode. But with my phone, I did not notice any major thing, and as many reviewers have mentioned it, these are still not that fast enough to be used for something like video editing. I mean, these are still Bluetooth earphones after all, and there will be that split second delay between audio and the actual video going on the device. So yeah, take it for what it is. Gaming mode or not, you will still have to be ready to deal with a slight amount of delay. It's definitely much lesser than some other counterparts I've seen in the market, but it's still not as good as Realme claims it to be. Okay, let's get to sound quality. The lack of rubber tip here isn't doing any favors for the Realme Buds when it comes to bass. These things have a very balanced sound, which I personally like a lot, but if you are looking to get a really good bass response out of these, even though Realme is claiming that it has bass boosted drivers, you will not be getting any elevated bass because a lot of environmental noise is creeping into your ears due to lack of proper sealing. So I did not have a very good experience listening to these while on public transport or while on a restaurant, because I could still hear the noise from outside and I had to crank up the volume to near 90%. And which is not a very great experience because these do not handle high volumes very well. But overall, I'm pretty surprised that they managed to deliver this kind of a sound in the first place, because I thought they would be like straight up trash and sound very tiny, because that's how AirPods sound when you connect them to an Android device. Fortunately, Realme hasn't done any proprietary chip technology with only Realme phones, and they perform the same with every Android phone with Bluetooth 5.0, so that's great. So if you're looking for a very good quality pair of earphones to listen in a moderately quiet room, you will have a fairly good experience with these when it comes to sound quality. Now let's get to my absolute favorite feature of these. Well, it's not really a feature, but more like a strong point of these. That's call quality. Calling on this has been a treat ever since I got them. It's the absolute best experience that I've ever had while calling anyone on a truly wireless earphone. Never once did I have to like take them out or switch back to my phone or ask them whether they can hear me well. They just worked very well. Even when I was outside and there was plenty of traffic noise, and even when I was upstairs on the terrace when there was plenty of wind noise, the other party could hear me fairly well, and I'm actually surprised. I recorded the call and listened back to my own voice, and it almost sounded like I'm speaking on loudspeaker on my phone's microphone. That's phenomenal, especially coming from such a tiny, truly wireless earphone with the microphone all the way up here. I'm actually impressed. During calls, both of their microphones act as primary microphones, meaning that you can talk with either the left one or only the right one or both of them together. So you don't have to have one of them on, and none of them act as a primary microphone. And because of the Realme R1 chip or something, they are always connected to one another. So you can just switch between them during call, and there won't be any like delay in audio, or there won't be any connection delay. So if you're wondering about the call quality on the Realme Buds Air, just know that it's fantastic. A couple of things to note, battery life is pretty great. Realme does claim around 17 hours of playback on this along with the cradle's battery, and it does kind of hold up. I did get around 14 hours of on and off usage, with the buds lasting me about 2 hours or maybe 2.5 hours, and the cradle lasting me a whole of 2-2.5 days on a single charge. It charges up fairly quickly with wireless charging, and even faster with the included Type-C port, so that's great. Although for some reason the Type-C port doesn't accept the USB Type-C plug all the way, so the plug is kind of exposed halfway, but it still charges somehow. But I don't like the way it looks. I don't like it. Unless it goes in all the way, I'm not satisfied. That's what she said. But the case itself, while being very tiny and easy to carry, it does have slight design flaws, or rather the structural flaws if you will. The lid is a little bit looser than I thought because it does wobble around, but that was the case with the Apple AirPods as well, and by willingly or unwillingly, Realme did copy the same thing. The lid is a little bit loose. Now it's not going to be wobbling when in your pocket or something, but if you purposefully try to like move those things around, it doesn't feel like a singular solid latch mechanism, but it kind of feels like a plastic thing which is on top of your cradle, which could fly off even with a minor drop. So yeah, don't go about dropping these, or your AirPods for that matter. Even though these things cost literally 1/3 of the Apple AirPods, it's always a good practice to take care of them. A few things can be improved here, like a notification LED over here that when every time you open the lid, for 3 seconds it shows you the battery indication on the charging case. If it's green, it means it's fully charged. Orange would stand for about 50%, and red would mean it's on low battery. That is not visible outdoors. Only indoors you can see the indicator, but outdoors you can barely see it with your eyes. Like, you have to cover with your hands and move into the shadows. So if that would be a little bit brighter, it would like really be more convenient. Oh, and not to mention, please change the sound effect that you get when you enter and exit gaming mode. Even though it's cool to have a little bit of lesser latency when you're gaming on these things, that is just absolute cringy. So please remove that, or at least change it to something else. And that is the conclusion of my experience with the Realme Buds Air over the past few days. They are a fantastic pair of earphones. I mean, you can't go wrong with purchasing them. It's just that don't keep your expectations higher than what they should be. These are exactly like Apple AirPods, meaning that you should not expect them to perform better than Apple AirPods, obviously. All things considered, I think Realme Buds Air are a pretty solid pair of truly wireless earphones, especially for those who are looking under the budget of 5,000 rupees. Should you buy them? Yeah, I think you should buy them. Because right now, I can't think of another option which can quite match them in terms of the quality, the call quality, the overall package for the price. So I think I can finally say one of the earphones out there is better than my daily driver Sennheiser BS-01 truly wireless earphones. These now sound way too bass heavy to me, because I am used to the somewhat neutral and well balanced sound signature out of these. It's funny, because they were meant for heavy bass, but they are not delivering heavy bass. But in contrast, they are delivering a lot more pleasant sound quality than actual bass heavy earphones like the BS-01s right here. But if they somehow manage to improve the fit and they don't feel so loose around my ears, that will give me and other users more confidence to wear them around more often. Okay, so those were my thoughts on the Realme Buds Air. I'll leave a link in the description if you would like to check one out for yourself. You'll also find a link to my blog, dopetechfever.com. I also have another channel now, I think you know. I'm posting some other kind of tech content there, so you can check it out. Until next time, take it easy, and I will see you soon.